That is why people say Buddhism is a gentle religion, never ridicule others. We practice our religion and allow others to practice their religion without interfering, without disturbing. But others cannot practice their religion without disturbing us. Therefore, Buddhism is a gentle religion. You can understand why we have chosen Buddhism, why we practice Buddhism. This freedom is there. We have freedom to think, freedom to talk, freedom to ask questions, and freedom to doubt. The Buddha encouraged us to doubt, and then you get better knowledge. Don't accept at once, without thinking, without doubting, without investigating. Don't accept anything. Just like scientific analysis. This is the Buddha's way of teaching.
其他的宗教徒谴责我们说是罪人，他们要我们改信他们的宗教。可是佛法或是佛陀的教言从来没有说过不可以去听、去研究、去看、去接触其他的宗教。佛法从来没有说其他的宗教徒都是罪人，都应该谴责的，都应该改信佛教的。佛陀反而告诉我们说，尊敬那些值得你尊敬的人，任何人值得你尊敬，你就要尊敬他。因此我们尊敬耶稣基督，我们尊敬先知穆罕默德，我们尊敬 Krishna， 我们尊敬 Rama。 我们修持佛法的当下，我们也尊敬其他值得我们尊敬的人物。佛陀鼓励我们去研究、去思维、去请教其他的宗教。佛陀教诫我们不可以轻易的相信，如果你没有经过思维，没有经过分析，没有经过体验的话，千万不要盲目的相信。佛陀并没有禁止我们去研究其他的宗教，佛陀要我们尊重其他的宗教，佛陀甚至要求我们要怀疑佛所说的话对不对。千万不要没有经过思维羞耻就盲目相信佛陀所说的话，这就是一种科学的研究态度。任何一件事情都必须经过真正的体验、真正的证明之后才能够接受的。我们为什么信仰佛教？我们为什么修持佛法呢？那是因为佛陀给我们自由，给我们自由去思维，给我们自由去说，给我们自由去修持，从来没有限制我们，给我们完全的自由。
The Buddha always encouraged people to ask questions. He never advised people to accept anything. You see, don't accept anything whatever I have preached, thinking the Buddha is a great man. You never understand the truth. Don't depend on that person. You had to think, you had to doubt, you had to investigate, then you can understand.
That is his way of life. But other religionists don't like to asking questions. Take for instance, one day when a preacher was giving a talk about the creation, he started his talk at the beginning when the God started to create heaven and earth. Somebody interrupted and asked one question. May I know what was he doing before he started to create heaven and earth? It's a terrible question, no one can answer. Then the preacher said, I think at that time he was creating hell for those who ask this kind of questions. This is the way, when you compare with the Buddha's teaching and all the other existing religions, they are scared of the question. The Buddha has revealed the truth. If there is truth, if it is the ultimate truth, why should we worry about question? The answer is there.
佛陀鼓励弟子们去怀疑、去思维，他告诉弟子说：“你们不要相信我是一个圣人，除非你们经过自己的思维、研究、探究，绝对不要轻易的相信我所说的话。”这种态度是在其他宗教里面所没有的。其他的宗教总是禁止他们的信徒来怀疑、来发问，唯有佛陀是例外。有一位传教士，他在布道的时候说明到上帝造我世间造万物的情形。他说，上帝呢，首先创造了天地。有一个听众就打断了他的话，问他，请你告诉我们，那么上帝他为什么创造了天地，还要再创造地狱呢？他为什么要创造地狱呢？那个传教士无法回答，他只好说，可能上帝当时是因为没有办法回答这个问题，所以才创造的地狱。那这种方式呢，禁止宗教徒来怀疑、来发问，在佛教里面是没有的。佛陀鼓励我们呢，去怀疑、去思维、去探究，才能够发现诸法的终极实相。唯有透过这个闻思修，透过这个体证，才能够真正的了知世间的真实面目。
The Buddha introduced this religion for us to practice without becoming slaves either to the Buddha or to any god or anybody. Independent life, or without behaving like children. Dr. Paul Dahlke, a German Buddhist scholar, says, all the other existing religions are like small children. Because children always depend on others. They have to depend on others. They don't know how to produce their things. But Buddhism is like an adult. An adult does not depend on others. He or she knows how to prepare their things and without depending on others. So independent religion as adult, not as a child. This is the opinion given by the Western scholar. Another scholar says, Buddhism is a religion of freedom and reason. Freedom is there, but with reasoning. When they use this reasoning, they can practice this religion freely, without depending on authorities, without following their orders, commandments, religious punishment, religious laws. In Buddhism, there are no religious laws. The teachings of the Buddha, he introduced in such a way, not a single word there we can point out as a law. It is an advice. He says, how nice if you can keep away from killing others. It is not a law. Then he says, if you cannot understand why it is wrong, then you have to think in this way. Attanam upamam katva nahaneyana ghate. When another person come and try to kill you, how do you feel? That feeling is enough for you to understand why it is wrong. Therefore, it is not a law come down from heaven or given by the God or given by the Buddha for us to understand by thinking. The religion that it encourages for people to think and to understand, that is Buddhism.
佛陀至少这个宗教是要我们不做 任何宗教，任何神，甚至于不做佛的奴隶，要我们完全的自由，自由的想，自由的发问，自由的羞耻，一切呢，都是掌握在我们自己的手中。 一切我们都是可以独立做主的，并不是幼稚的宗教。有一个有名的德国学者巴卡博士他这么说：佛教是成人的宗教，佛教不是小孩子的宗教。 因为小孩子不能够独立的思考，小孩子必须仰仗别人来帮他料理生活的一切，而成人会独立的思考，不必仰仗别人，自己呢就可以独立的生活。佛教呢，就是这么一个成人的 宗教绝对不是一个幼稚的宗教。另外一位有名的学者也这么写道：佛教是一个自由而理性的宗教，佛教里面给予他的信徒充分的自由，同时还强调理性。 理性就是透过一种思维、一种推理，透过自己的探究的。因此呢，佛教是一个独立、是一个理性、是一个自由的宗教。Scientists
have discovered so many things which contradict to many of those religions, theories, beliefs that people maintain. But so far, they could not discover anything which will contradict to the teachings of the Buddha. The more they discover, the more they come nearer to the Buddha. But go far away from other religions. Take for instance, theory of evolution, Charles Darwin explained how evolution has taken place. Church has a losing battle for a long period. Recently, Pope the head of the Catholic Church, announced, it appeared in the newspaper, human beings were not created by the God, Pope says. They come into existence due to evolution. They had to say this. S.G. Wells, a well-known historian, he says, when you study our holy book, this earth and human life is not more than 4,000 years old. God created earth and human beings 4,000 years ago. But when you study biology, theology, not theology, biology, we can understand this earth has taken millions of years to cool down. How can we believe that God created this within 4,000 years ago? Bertrand Russell, a well-known Western philosopher who has no religion, he says, among the founders of all the existing religions, although I have no religion, I respect only one man. He used this word, only one man. Why? All the others tried to tell us how this world came into existence, who created this, at what time this world was created. But the Buddha never uttered even one word. Who created this world? Because he knew what this world is. Those who have made false statements that so and so created this world was never knew the nature of the world. Therefore, I respect the Buddha. Even free thinkers, agnostics, who have no religions, also respect the Buddha. He is the one who revealed the truth.
科学家研究我们这个世界有许多的发现，科学发现越多，越跟其他的宗教教义有所不同，唯有佛教，科学越发达，越接近佛教的教理。 科学越来越证明佛所说的话是真理。比如说，其他的宗教认为人万物都是由神所创造的，可是达尔文提出了进化论。 进化论解释我们这个世界是如何演进的，他这理论跟基督教的教义有所冲突，在长久的论断斗争之中，最后基督教投降了。最近天主教的教皇 公开的宣布，报纸上也有刊载。教皇他说：“人不是由上帝所创造的，人是进化而来的。为什么？我们只要研究地理学的话，就可以发现。” 基督教所说，神是在4000年前创造的人类，可是地理学却告诉我们，地球是经过几百万年的时间才冷却下来的，怎么可能上帝在4000年前创造的人类呢？又有一位科学家 见，他这么说，人万物是有很多很多的因素所进化所演变而出来的，并不是由哪一个造物主依照他的旨意在什么时候创造了哪一样东西的。还有无神论者罗素他这么写道，在圣经所有的宗教创造主里面，我主我只尊敬一个人，他说是人，我只尊敬一个人，因为其他的宗教主都是这么说，而是神创造了万物，可是他们并没有办法知道为什么要创造万物的性质何在。只有一个人他不这么说，他晓得这些万法的性质是什么，因此呢我尊敬他。即使是一个无神论者，他也尊敬释迦牟尼佛的理论，他认为啊，在所有的宗教徒里面值得他尊敬的只有这么一个人。
The freedom that you experience as Buddhist I don't think you can find in many other religions because they were forbidden to do many things, to eat certain things and so many restrictions. According to the Buddha, you are at liberty, but he has paved the way for you to open your mind and think and understand whether it is right or wrong. Instead of taking as a law to obey, you come to your own conclusion by knowing what it is, whether right or wrong. Take for instance family planning. Some religions cannot agree. They say it is against the will of God. Buddhists have no problem at all. They are at liberty to practice any precaution, any method to avoid conception, conceivement. That is the freedom. There are so many other kind of freedom that we experience in our Buddhist way of life, but others are restricted as they are religious, according to their religious commandment or principles or religious laws. So still many people do not know how to appreciate what sort of freedom they experience, they enjoy as Buddhist.
佛陀的教法从来没有说他是上帝给他的，或者是他是强制命令的，他给学佛的人充分的自由。比如说提到不杀生，佛陀就不说这是佛要你不杀生，或者是神要你不杀生的，他只是叫我们自己来思维。如果有一个人来到你的面前要求你的生命，你愿意吗？如此来叫这些学佛人呢能够思维不杀生的意义何在，不杀生的好处何在。佛陀给我们充分的自由，在我们学佛的过程之中我们所享受到的自由，我相信啊，你在其他的宗教里面从来不会有过的。比如说家庭计划的问题，其他的宗教就认为跟他们的上帝旨意，跟他们宗教的 教条有所违反，因此不可以实施家庭计划。可是佛法的说法就不是这个样子，他认为你们自己要做自己的决定，你没有充分的自由去为你自己来选择来负责任。其他的宗教有许多许多的限制，有许多许多的教条，有许多许多有神有命令有宗教有传教士所给予的规范的规定，限制很多，唯有这个佛教给我们的所有一切的自由，要我们自由去想，要我们自由去思维，要我们自由去怀疑，要我们自由去体证，要我们自己去发现。我们许多学佛人呢还不知道，在你学佛的过程中你享受了有多少的自由啊。
We started at 7:30, now 10:15. I don't know whether this clock is right or wrong. 10:15. I think these few points that I have mentioned are more than enough for you to understand why you practice Buddhism. Thank you very much.
我们从7:30开讲，一直到现在的已经将近10:15。我所举的这些例子呢，我相信呢，就足以让诸位来明白为什么你要信佛，为什么你要修持佛法了。谢谢诸位。
我们很感谢我们的长老这么好的开这个开示，这个句句都是真理，我们非常感谢他。还有我们这个鸠摩罗什在线，我这个是像录音像录音机一样啊，他马上录下来，又马上要放出来，另一种声道又放出来，真不简单，那么长的一个。
He's a wonderful interpreter.
Yeah, very wonderful.
Although I cannot understand Chinese, but when he explains, I can understand what he says.
非常的不简单，非常这个，我们非常感谢这两位这么好的。这么好的这个翻译，还有这么好的开始，好，谢谢诸位，今天我们就到这边，谢谢。